Hi children, now let us move on to the second part of the lesson, the little girl. So now we know how she felt about her father, how she was beaten by father for taking something which was did not belong to her, and how she observed another family where a father played with five children, laughed with them, and she realized that there were different sorts of fathers. Now we move on. Suddenly one day, mother became ill and she and grandmother went to hospital. The little girl was left alone in the house with Alice the cook. That was all right in the daytime. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. So nothing to explain there. Mother, one day it happened that mother was not well and mother and grandmother went to hospital. So the girl was alone in the house with the cook in the daytime. That was okay. Daytime, she was not afraid. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. What will I do if I have a nightmare? She asked. Nightmare is bad dream. I often have nightmares and then Granny takes me into her bed. I can't stay in the dark. It all gets whispery. So she says that what will I do if I get a nightmare? Usually what happens if I have, and I often have nightmares also, and grandmother takes me into her bed. Now what can I do? I can't stay in the dark. You just go to sleep, child, said Alice, pulling off her socks. And don't you scream and wake your poor pa. And don't scream in the night and awaken your father, poor father. But the same old nightmare came. The butcher with a knife and a rope, who came nearer and nearer, smiling that dreadful smile, while she could not move, could only stand still, crying out, Grandma, Grandma. She woke shivering to see father beside her bed, a candle in his hand. What's the matter? He said. Oh, a butcher, a knife. I want Granny. He blew out the candle, bent down, and caught up the child in his arms, carrying her along the passage to the big bedroom. A newspaper was on the bed. He put away the paper, then carefully tucked up the child. He lay down beside her, half asleep still. Still with the butcher's smile all about her, it seemed, she crept close to him, snuggled her head under his arm, held tightly to his shirt. Tucked her means covered up nicely in bed. So the father came when she screamed. She had the same nightmare, but father came, took her to his room. And maybe he was reading newspaper. The newspaper was there. He kept it away aside and made her comfortable. Snuggled means moved into a warm, comfortable position close to another person. So that itself shows that the girl felt safe, secure. Then the dark did not matter. See that? When she lay beside her father, the dark did not matter. She lay still. Here, rub your feet against my legs and get them warm, said father. Tired out, he slept before the little girl. A funny feeling came over her. Poor father. Not so big after all, and with no one to look after him. He was harder than grandmother, but it was a nice hardness. And every day he had to work and was too tired to be a Mr. MacDonald. She had torn up all his beautiful writing. She stirred suddenly and sighed. What's the matter? Asked her father. Another dream? Oh, said the little girl. My head is on your heart. I can hear it going. What a big heart you have got, father dear. Okay, the story ends actually. So, the father, here the girl gets a different picture of her father. She had always thought of father as a giant. All the physical features, what she explained, she had such a negative impression about her father. But when an opportunity came, when he felt that she was alone and she was afraid, father came to her rescue. For the father, a night dream, a small night dream, he could have scolded her. What is this? Go to sleep. I am so tired. Right. But then he took care of her. And before she slept, she realized that he was so tired. That is why he couldn't play like Mr. MacDonald. Understand? And she felt guilty that she had torn up all the beautiful writing. And also look at that line. Poor father, not so big. So now that shows that it is our perspective. Now when she saw the good nature of her father, that all that she had thought that big, which she said that is not that big, and with no one to look after him. So sympathetic also to father, that there is no one to look after him. Understand? So that it brought about a change in her attitude towards her father. She understood. She understood her father's situation. Why he behaved like that? Why he didn't play with her? So this, look at the last line, is actually symbolic. What a big heart you have got. Till then, she was always saying big hand, big neck, and finally she said, what a big heart you have got. Understand? That shows her attitude change, her perspective about her father changed. So this again tells us that it is our attitude that matters a lot. It's how you look at things influences you a lot, isn't it? And with a proper understanding, you understand things better also. Here earlier, she didn't try to understand her father. To her, her father was almost like a giant, or something to be afraid of. She never tried. Why he didn't play? Now, when an opportunity came, she realized that, and that brought about a change in her attitude. So you can actually assess your relationship with your parents. If you had any sort of, you can analyze whether it is like that. Why your parents behave to you? Why are they like that? You may get an answer. So use this opportunity for that also actually. So that is the lesson. Read the lesson, write the notes, and do the assignment. Thank you, children.